Yes, thank you, Paul and organization for giving this opportunity to talk a little bit about our practice in the Eurodelta. My name is Robert Broussy. I'm Dutch. I'm one of the founders of MAST, an office for urban planning and design based in Amsterdam and in Cologne. In 2012, I moved for personal reasons to Cologne, and then we also started the department of MAST there. We always had a fascination for this big scale of the Eurodelta, but because we now have the two offices on different spots in the Eurodelta, our office is also in its daily practice very actively involved in planning the Eurodelta. I'm just going to give a short pitch about the kind of work we are dealing with. You see here a series of three maps that we produced for the SURE network, where you see different mega regions in the world. The Eurodelta is one of these regions that is competing with other regions, mega regions in the world, and where the competition is very high. Therefore, we think it's very important to see how the cooperation in the Eurodelta can be strengthened. A few years ago, in 2015, we produced a map for the so-called Rhine-Ruhr corridor. On the left, you see, let's say, the Netherlands, and on the right, you see part of North Rhine-Westphalia. In this map, we mapped the different kind of developments and challenges that are taking place in this area. What it shows is that you have, of course, the urbanized regions, and they are connected by a series of different corridors. These corridors are facing a series of challenges that we also discussed in the so-called corridor conference that took place in 2018. We were asked to produce what they called a fact note for this conference. In this fact note, a series of challenges and chances for the Eurodelta were being described. Maybe the most central issue is that we said that the cross-border connectivity and complementarity, because you have regions that are very complementary in this Eurodelta, is an important asset in the economic vitality and livability of this core European region. That's another issue I think we should stress, is that we should be aware that the Eurodelta is the core economic region of Europe. This is the place where most money is earned, where most people live, and where most innovation takes place. This can only be strengthened if we also enhance the cooperation with the different parts within this region. In order to do this, we need a strategic perspective that is borderless and that aligns the collaboration among the main public and private stakeholders. I think what Alan-Grieter just said, that make this difference between, let's say, the private stakeholders and the main public is very important, and also how to see how we can connect them. There are a series of issues that this area has to deal with, which has to do with livability and environment and climate change, with multimodal infrastructure performance. We need integral strategies for urban planning and infrastructure planning. There are a lot of issues concerning infrastructure maintenance and logistic and freight if we want to strengthen this region. Just as an example, here you see a map that we produced for this fact note about the infrastructure with the expected bottlenecks in the coming years. If you look well at this map, you see that the most bottlenecks are in, let's say, the most urbanized regions in the west of the Netherlands, to put it simple, in the region around Antwerp and Brussels, and in the corridor between Düsseldorf and Cologne. These are the areas where, let's say, the transit transport is in conflict with regional and local transport, where there's a lot of pressure on the infrastructure. Where you also have the conflict between the need for infrastructure and mobility on the one side, and a big pressure on the urban development on the other side. I think what we try to do as an office is also to to transfer knowledge from one country to the other all the time. And for example, in the Netherlands, we were involved in a lot of so-called MEERT projects, which try to solve these infrastructure issues for the highways combined with spatial developments. And I think that's something we now, for example, we try also to introduce and to help people in the North Rhine-Westphalia to implement this way of thinking and acting. But it's also a lot about regional planning. In the Netherlands, I think the Netherlands has a really good tradition in the field of regional planning, integral planning, in bringing people together in an informal way. And here you see an example of a map of the so-called gebiedsagendas in the Netherlands. And this is also something we now try to transfer to parts of Germany. A third issue is climate adaptation. I think we don't have to discuss about this. And in the Netherlands, especially, I think already even before it was called like this, we were dealing with a lot of issues in the field of water on different scales, on a regional scale, water issues along the big rivers, but also on a smaller scale in the cities. And our office in Cologne is producing and working on a lot of projects in this field. And we were surprised, actually, this knowledge, we can also partly play back to our office in Amsterdam, where they applied it in Dutch projects. So all the time you have this kind of knowledge transfer. All these issues come actually together in what Paul already introduced, the so-called agglomeration concept, the agglomeration concept for the region of Cologne and Bonn. In the region of Cologne and Bonn, about 3.6 million people are living there, and it's facing the kind of issues that I think most urbanized regions are facing, climate change here, especially energy change, because we still have a few very big brown coal mines here that are going to be closed, and a lot of pressure on the infrastructure. And the region Cologne-Bonn is an informal, let's say, constitution of different kinds of organizations. All the municipalities are part of this organization, but also private banks, the Chamber of Commerce, etc. And it's an organization that brings all these people together, maybe a way with what we do now on a big scale on the Euro Delta, but here in small, only for 3.6 million people. Where they try to enhance the cooperation between these municipalities and improve the cooperation. And one of the things they did is to organize an agglomeration concept. You can say it's a kind of regional concept for this area. And it was completely new for the people here. And the way they did this is that they invited four teams with different disciplines. So infrastructure planning, urban planning, and landscape. And these four teams were asked to produce a vision for this area. It was a long process. It was a process of about 3 years in total, where all the time people from the whole region were being invited and to discuss with these teams about their visions. In the end, all these visions were brought together, and from that, one vision for the region was being produced. I think this this kind of informal planning we know from the Netherlands, but maybe not on this scale already. And I think that is something maybe that we could play back again to our colleagues in the Netherlands. This is something that also could be adapted there, but also, of course, in other parts of the Euro Delta. One of the issues we proposed in our proposal for this agglomeration concept was the so-called triple densification, a densification strategy that not only focuses on densification of buildings, but also densification of mobility concepts, and also densification of green and blue structures. And this is an issue now that has been very strongly worked on in this region, because we simply have very little room for new developments. We worked out this densification strategy for an area in Bonn. But because of this, let's say, this densification issue, we were also asked by the region Cologne-Bonn to go with 20 planners from the region to the Netherlands and visit there a lot of projects, talk with planners about densification strategies, and also to help them understand how densification can also come up with new or can produce new kinds of qualities. And I think this interaction is maybe something what we also try to do in the Euro Delta. We as an office have a very small part in it and try to contribute there and bring our part to that. And that was my pitch for this moment, Paul.